all take bath for our body using various shampoos, soaps, etc., etc. But do we take bath for the mind? Mind has so much dirt in it. Many of us mind is so much dirt in it that is the cause of all illnesses from common cold to cancer. Even to get a common cold, you must get some frustration in life. Common cold is not due to the germ. The germ is there in your nose all the 12 months of the year, 365 days. Not one germ, 80 genera of 1,000 germs. But they can give you cold anytime you pull down your immune guard by getting frustrated. Let us say you lose an election. Then you say, my God, you know, gone. So you're frustrated. Next day you start sneezing. To cancer, all diseases are due to the environment, that is the mind. So we must cultivate a healthy mind. How to cultivate a healthy mind? What's a healthy mind? Now, definition of healthy mind. A mind filled with enthusiasm to work. And a mind filled with enthusiasm to be compassionate. Imagine we change our education system in this country or in the world. What is the education system today? Trying to make a wealthy career. I want to be an engineer. I want to be a doctor. I want to be a technologist. I want to be an engineer. Money, money making. On the contrary, if you aim education at making a healthy mind, imagine 1.3 billion healthy minds here, 2.6 billion hands wanting to work. Can anybody beat this country? 2.6 billion hands wanting to be compassionate. Is there any problem? Is there any murder, rape, terrorism, hatred, jealousy, anger, pride? Nothing. And that should be our aim. I've been telling the education is what education is all about. Education is not teaching 3 hours that anybody understands. Nobody can teach anybody anything that he or she does not already know, because on the day you are made, that zygote is so unique that it knows all about this universe post or in priori when it gets its consciousness. The human mind is human consciousness. Human mind is not in the brain. A lot of people have the misconception that the mind is in the brain. No, mind is not in the brain. Actually, the man who got the Nobel Prize is saying that the mind is in the brain, a Canadian neurosurgeon called Wilder Penfield, in 1971 said, I'm sorry, I did a mistake. Brain cannot even hold a thought. Forget about the mind. Mind is a huge canvas, universal canvas, on which our thoughts are projected. And that's called consciousness. And Max Planck, the father of quantum physics, says, consciousness is fundamental. And all else, including matter, comes from consciousness. So if you understand this, I tell you how to cure yourself. You don't have to go to a doctor, you don't have to take any medicine. Any disease from common cold to cancer can be treated. All that you know is, this matter and mind change so fast, so quickly, and for every second in the human body, it changes 1,024 times. It's called the Max Planck's constant. And each time the energy knows the blueprint to the matter. Supposing a man has a cancer, let us say, he knows how to meditate intensely and really gets into that level of consciousness where he says, look, my cancer now can go with the next set of energy, converting that matter into a new matter. You go on doing that and you can beautifully heal it. It's a little difficult. You require a little patience, practice. It's not a quick fix like you have a headache, you swallow a pill. But you don't know what happens to the pill. There is no pill for every ill, but there is an ill following every pill. Every painkiller, from an ordinary paracetamol to Vioxx, has got so much of side effects that one can get a heart attack in the next 5 years. Just taking paracetamol. I was told I have to check on this fact. The Parsis keep their dead bodies on the top. You know, the vultures. And a lot of vultures recently have died in Bombay, I believe. Dissected vultures showed a lot of paracetamol inside their bodies. Because old people, you know, take a lot of painkillers and then their body is full of paracetamol there, they're taken up. In a small country like England, 2,500 people died last year of paracetamol poisoning. Not large doses. Even one pill of paracetamol is enough. It is not dose related. And damages the kidney and damages the liver directly. One of the common causes of kidney dialysis, transplants, is NSAID-induced kidney disease. It's called pain killer nephropathy. I'm just talking of one. So every pill has an ill, but quantum healing has nothing, because you're not putting in anything. Your own body corrects itself. If you want, as a layman, to read, know what it is, there's a nice book, read it. It's called Quantum Doctor. Quantum Doctor. Okay, if you want to quickly know what it is, you go to the internet and put my name and say quantum healing, you get an article, you can read it. But this is a nice book written by a professor of quantum physics in the University of Eugene in Oregon. He's an Indian, a big quantum physicist, Amit Goswami. His name is Amit, A-M-I-T, Goswami. It's a beautiful book, a small book, a readable book, understandable book, and you will know how to cure yourself of many ills. Only thing is, you need patience. Ayurveda knew this thousands of years ago. So beautifully said, diseases start in the mind and end in the mind. And where is the mind? Never mind. It's everywhere. It's everywhere. In every cell of your body, the mind is there. Even outside, there is mind. And today we know quantum physics, non-locality. If I want to convey something in my mind to your mind, I can do that. Experiments show that. I can induce a wave with electrically stimulated wave, what's called an induced wave in my brain. I can pass it on to your brain. That is how the mystics pass on their ideas to others. That's how in the olden days, the great teachers passed on their ideas to their students. And this is possible because it is non-locality. Everything happens at every. You intensely want to talk to somebody, your relative maybe in Boston. You intensely, really intend to talk something and you can't get it. You will be surprised. Within 24 hours, either that man or woman will contact you, or you will get a phone call or some sort of a thing. It's called telepathy, which today science says transmutation, telemutation. You can convey an idea from one place to another place without any conventional methods of communication and without loss of time. That's the most beautiful thing. It immediately happens. When a photon jumping about here, another photon counterpart will be jumping about in the person's. I have a friend of mine in London. That man so beautifully times my, you know, he talks to me twice a day, wherever I am, and that he has to talk every day twice. And he times it in such a way. Today, for example, I just came from Bangalore and I got in the airport, came to my hotel, checked into my room, he rings me up. Then I said, Linus, how did you do that? I don't know, I got an intuition that you are in the room, so I'm ringing your room. I told him which hotel I'm staying. He will immediately go to Google and find out about the hotel. I didn't know the number of the hotel myself. But as I was getting into the room, opened the door, got into the room, he rings up. And this happens day in and day out, every day. And twice a day, he rings me up. This is called telepathy. This is very interesting. And body can now, my friend was saying that I have to take vitamin D, vitamin C, as my friend, that, you know, CoQ and things like that. Your body knows all that. It can transmute anything to anything. Supposing your magnesium is lacking, it can take sodium and make it into magnesium. What happens is, we know a few things. We know a few chemical reactions. But in the cell, in one cell, in 1 minute, there are 3 million reactions occur. And we won't be able to control that. That's why in the intensive care unit, a lot of people are sent to heaven by us, because we just have a few parameters, we try to adjust that, and that goes haywire. But when the body wants, it can transmute anything to anything. This is called transmutation. And such a beautiful thing. You want sodium? Sodium will come. You want potassium? Potassium will come. And everything will happen on its own, provided you don't too much interfere from outside. That's why Ayurveda says, Hita Mita Ahara Sevi. This is your future for how to... Hita means what you love. Don't say, oh, that's this and this is fried, that is this and that's cholesterol. That itself is stress. Kills you. Nothing. You like something, eat it. But mita, anything in moderation is okay. Even poison is okay. You know, if you get a heart attack and come to us, do you know what we give? Rat poison. What is warfarin? Rat poison. Only small dose, that's all. If you give a bigger dose, the rat will bleed and die. If I give you a small dose, your blood will be fluid so that it doesn't clot. That's why we check your blood every now and then, because you may bleed somewhere. I still remember my professor in Scotland used to put a board when first warfarin came to the thing. No rat poison in my ward. He never allowed that. Till he died, he never allowed warfarin to come to his ward. And that's the beauty of it. So what I'm saying is, anything in moderation is okay. Hita, mita, ahara, sevi. Samikshakari, work very hard. Nobody has died of working. Nobody has died of working. If you love your work, you can work very hard. If you hate your work, you will die overworking. That's what happens in the IT industry. The boys and girls don't like the work. Because same repetition, same thing, you know, you just, that's no innovation, no creativity, nothing. America has given something, you just go on producing it day in and day out, and then there's no 9-to-5 job. You are given a project that is about three, you know, a whole day, night sometimes. And the parents think, you know, it's very nice because they're given a hotel. They're given a hotel because they can't go home at 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock in the night. So this is kind of a job. When you hate your job, you kill yourself. When you love your job, work very hard. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Actually, you improve.